how do you price your house properly when selling in South Florida? So there are a lot of online home value estimation tools that you can find just by playing online. One of the most popular is Zillow's Zestimate tool. So Zillow gives you a Zestimate of your home's value on just about every single property in America. And that is just an algorithm that Zillow has. It takes into consideration the number of bedrooms, the number of bathrooms, you know, the average price per square foot in your area. So it's a good starting point, but it's not the end all be all, and you have to be careful by taking that too seriously. If you actually read the fine print on Zillow's Zestimate in South Florida, their median margin of error, they put it right there in black and white on their website, it's 7.3%. So 50% of the time, their Zestimate is within 7.3% of the true value of the home. And then 50% of the time, it's more than 7.3%. So let's put that into hard numbers for you. If you have a $400,000 house, the median error rate of 7.3% means that Zillow's Zestimate could be high or low by $29,000. That's a lot of money. So if you're underpricing your house by $29,000, you are leaving serious money on the table. And if you're overpricing it by almost $30,000, it's gonna sit for a long time. The Zestimate does not take into consideration the condition of your home, the upgrades, and certain other features that Zillow just can't take into consideration. For example, school districts. Down here, if you're on one side of the street, you might be in a completely different school district than you would be if you were on the other side of the street, and that could play a huge role in the end value of your home. Same thing if you're waterfront. A home on the other side of the street that's not on the waterfront might not be anywhere near as valuable as the home on this side of the street that's waterfront. Fixed bridges versus no fixed bridges. There are a lot of factors that come into play that these online algorithms just can't calculate properly. So make sure you're speaking with a true professional to get the real value of your property. So how do we get the real value of your property? Well, we look at the recent sales in your neighborhood. So if an appraiser is gonna come out to your house today, what they're gonna look at is within your neighborhood, which homes have sold within the last 3 to 6 months. They're not gonna go back longer than 6 months because that's just too long, the market changes. And they're gonna look for homes that are most similar to yours. So if you have a 4-bedroom, 2-bath house with a pool on a dry lot, so no waterfront, that's what they're gonna be looking for in your neighborhood. They're not gonna compare it most likely to a 3-bedroom home. They're not gonna compare it to a home on the water. They're gonna look for as close to what you have as possible to make sure that they're seeing what other people are valuing these properties at to price yours correctly. So when you're going to sell the house, you have to keep in mind what's sold so you can price it correctly, but you also have to look at what's currently on the market. What's your active competition? If everyone else is way, way high, you may be able to push the price up a little bit. You still should be lower than what everyone else is if they're overshooting the price, but you may have some room to come up and try to bump the price up. On the opposite side, if everyone else is priced really, really low and they're, you know, giving their homes away because they want to move for whatever reason, that affects your value too. And you may have to be priced a little bit more competitively to keep up with the neighbors in the market. At the end of the day, whatever we sell the house for to a buyer, if they're getting a mortgage, the property still has to appraise. So we have to sell the house again. We have to sell the value to the appraiser. So we want to make sure that we're not overshooting, because even if we find someone who absolutely loves it and is willing to pay top dollar, if they're getting a mortgage, it still has to appraise, otherwise the deal is going to blow up and it's not gonna go through. So we have to be on point with our values. One tip I can give you is to preview the active competition in your neighborhood. If there are 3 or 4 other homes for sale at the same time as yours, maybe you wanna go to some of the open houses in your neighborhood, see what's been selling, see what the condition of those are, what they're asking, so you can get a better idea as to what buyers are actually going to be seeing when they walk into your direct competition. If someone's seeing one home in a neighborhood, it's a very good chance they're going to be seeing a few others because they like that neighborhood. So see what your competition is to make sure that you're priced correctly to compensate for the differences in the condition and the upgrades and the features of the homes. So that's how we price homes correctly. If you have any questions about any of this, give us a call, shoot us a text, send us an email, and I'll see you on the next video.